At Johns Hopkins, we've formed this multidisciplinary adult cranioplasty center based on our research, which shows that almost one out of every two patients who undergoes either neurosurgery procedure or a cranial surgery ends up with some type of deformity or indent on the side of their head.
In order to get to the problem that people need to have fixed, whether it's a brain tumor or an aneurysm, some other problem, we need to go through the scalp and the muscle and the skull. Even though we do our best to put everything back together the way it was, sometimes that's not possible. And people are left with an indentation. And it's those indentations that can be troubling to people. And many times people would like to improve their appearance and have these indentations fixed.
So as with any neurosurgical or craniofacial procedure, there's always risks related to any type of surrounding structure to the area being operated on. So that extends from the skin all the way down to the bone and to the underlying brain. By working together and experts in different fields, we believe that we're able to mitigate these risks and make them smaller, and at the same time, provide state-of-the-art options such as a new technique for which we've developed, which allows us to stay away from the brain versus the normal traditional way of performing a cranioplasty. The pericranial onlay cranioplasty is a new technique we've developed here at Johns Hopkins.
This new technique actually minimizes risk to the underlying brain and the covering of the brain. This is because instead of going through the previous scar, there's a new corridor that's created, and this allows the brain to stay protected throughout the whole procedure of the reconstruction.
We are open to evaluating all types of patients, whether it relates to just a missing muscle, an area of scar for which has an appearance deformity, or even someone who's missing a large portion of their skull that needs to be reconstructed.
Usually, the surgery is just a few hours, but a lot of the recovery depends on what the initial brain problem was and how involved the reconstruction is. On average, people need to be in the hospital about 2 to 3 days to allow for wound care and to make sure that their brain recovery is progressing as expected.